we say that so that the people who are coming last don't feel bad.
Now we've got to get the energy up for this final round.
Sounds good.
Second
to me.
Last round.
Okay.
Yeah, round three.
Do we have energy left, audience? We're about to do a captain's challenge round.
Yes, and captain of Scooby Snacks. Yeah.
So we have our captains going head to head to issue challenges to each respective team.
Just too much patchouli oil.
It was a great break.
Incense was going, it was all happening. Okay, captain's challenge.
Yes, you can please. Challenge Nicola, yes.
All right. Team to play a scene that involves war of some kind. Any kind of war, however you want to answer it.
Okay.
All right.
Sounds good.
Here we go.
A scene involving war, yes. And we'll get the rest of the team up, we'll help. For a scene involving war of any kind in our first captain's challenge. Oh. An American soap opera, okay.
Okay, we've got about two to 3 minutes. Ready to go, here we go. Scooby Snacks, soap opera, American style.
War is hell. Things will be different when we get home.
There is hope. Home is where the heart is.
My wife is a cardiologist. I'm afraid that's where my heart has to go.
Meanwhile, at home.
Jungle.
All right, we will perform our scene in the jungle as a
celebrities. Your first challenge is going to be a doozy. Get on in here. Okay, I know what about this cranky guy from the radio, this young starlet, and this teen heartthrob from Home and Away.
Challenge
as a team.
teenage endowments. And the way teenage endowments works, we are teenagers who have snuck out at night, gone off and done something dreadful, and they, when we come back, our parents are going to interrogate us and try and tell us what we've done with them, telling us what we've done, so they're going to give us hints. So what we're going to be going for is we've been out with a famous person, which you will give us in a minute after we go into the cone of silence. Famous person, where we've been, and what is our little misdemeanor that we did? What's wrong?
That's the need to be righted.
Who is going out?
Our teenagers?
That away,
we'll
guys.
Go to our soundproof.
I'll check them out.
Okay, and I trust that they will go into our soundproof room or at least cover their ears. Looking for a famous person. Not too shouty-shouty. And we'll just keep it down here. So from this section, we need a celebrity. Rose? No, we said a celebrity. Over here we need the misdemeanor. What they do? Oh, what was that? What was the other one? Oh, toilet paper. Yes, and where did they do it? Okay, so, still covered as we...
Still covered in the cone of silence.
Okay, so, we have toilet papered the White House with Whitney Houston. When she was alive.
Are we good to go? Yep.
Yes, we are ready.
Okay, come on back, guys. Here we go.
Of course, now, for our two teenagers, they don't know, and it's up to their teammates, without directly saying, to suggest what they may have done and see if they can guess it.
All right, your time starts in 5, 4, 3, 2.
Where do you think you've been? Sitting down here right now, your mother and I have been worried sick about you.
I didn't know you'd be up still.
Well, this is a real indictment on my parenting.
You've got to go to court next week for that speeding fine.
Do you think we've just been sitting here biding our time? No!
We love to go to the primaries in America.
Exactly!
Yeah, Celine Dion is here!
No!
That would have been great if you'd been
point as the scene finishes. Do we know what you two teens have done? John Tash, what do you think it is?
Protest.
Which was?
Riots.
At the White House.
At the White House, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Houston,
yes.
And on the paper on your foot was.
Oh, toilet paper!
Yes! Oh. Come on, John! Did you wipe your vagina with? Tash just thought, like, what a personal question to ask midway through a scene. Alright, leaves and twigs, okay?
Oh, there we go.
There we go, we got there in the end.
We did. Oh, thank goodness for that.
All right, yes. Now, of course, yes, challenge.
Mr. Indictment and Rowe, please join this team.
Oh, I think I just missed out on all that wonderful toilet paper thing. Sure, I will help.
My challenge is a simple one. Is we haven't used the prop box much today, so these three props will inform your characters. Whoever has them will use those props as something that informs what their characters are, and you can choose your own.
Okay, inform characters inspired by these artifacts or props. We're going to do a game called Sound Environment where you're going to help us. Whenever we say open the door, you are the sound effects department before electronics. So, for instance, I will come up and open the door, and you, as an ensemble, will break the door and the sound of the door opening.
Meanwhile, Rust Town, the recording studio!
in that history.
Oh boy.
That was both captains versus captains.
It was our two remaining captains. We've got Matilda and Vietnam vet.
Captain Ollie.
Classic
piece
of Australian food.
Ooh!
Pineapple
and
burger,
okay.
Classic bit of Aussie food somewhere in your seat.
Chicken
roll!
Alright, bring out the rest of the pets. You need anything else from
us? Discuss sponsor of Australian food time.
Everybody is terrified.
Okay, how are we going there?
Are you
going to do
the... Well, what's your food? We'll find out in the scene. I think we'll work it out.
All right.
Oh, Georgie's in front.
So in this scene, Nick or Rome will call out character swap, and everyone who's on stage has to switch which role they are playing.
With a classic piece of
Aussie food.
Aussie food. Yeah. Sweet, beautiful. Here we go, in 5, 4, 3, 2.
Things the tax write-off for you. Any location. The crucifixion. Hospital, the moon. You have had a moon today.
I'm painted!
Do you like matches?
Matches! Feels like a good day for a crucifixion, apparently. Using the soccer ball. Football.
Love that last scene.
Yes.
Love it about the 15 seconds of dancing in the end.
Oh, isn't it great?
We're going all in. We're going to do a ballet.
Oh! Right. What our Lord and Savior would have wanted.
Can we get the scoring department
into
it?
Yeah!
All right. Woo. That's the need,
Here we go. We've got Matilda, it's the ballet. With a soccer ball.
With a soccer ball. Here we go. Around the crucifixion.
Oh, but of course. In 5, 4, 3, 2...
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Enmore Theatre Ballet Players' performance of Tchaikovsky's little-known Christ the Crucifixion. Christ is in the warm-up position and adopts the pose of the Messiah. His most honest and friendly disciple, Peter, enters stage right. Compared to the pain in his heart, because he knows he has betrayed his Messiah. He dances the dance of the guilty betrayer. Suddenly, Mary Magdalene enters stage right. Jesus' one true lover, taken from the streets as a woman of ill repute, the only person who's ever held Jesus' heart. They dance the dance of unforbidden love between a Messiah and a human. Suddenly, from the heavens, descends a perfect sphere. A sphere sent by God himself. And only if this sphere can remain off the ground for 15 seconds can Jesus be saved. They do the dance of 1 in 3 and 3 in 1. All of this amuses Paul Michael, who was crucified earlier that afternoon. He dances the dance of jealousy because he's clearly completely screwed and nailed at the same time. But wait, a miracle! Jesus steps forward and with one glance liberates Michael from the cross.
Oh, what an extraordinary round that was.
Oh, I didn't even sit down. It was so extraordinary.
Sit down. We've got a little bit more. to do.
Ah, and also duty commitments and nearly splitting your pants.
Oh my goodness. Again, Bernie David.
Yes. The sound of laser eyes bringing a crucified person back to life. I didn't realise you had it in you.
Groovy, it was hip, it was happening, it was, oh wow.
Is that everybody challenged?
Blew my top.
We've had all our challenges done?
Well, that is it.
That is
so
it.
So now it gets to a very exciting point. We are going to be drawing that raffle, but first, we're going to throw to Geordie, our scorekeeper.
Our scorekeeper.
To find out just exactly
who is
there, who is where, how's it all rolling.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. Here we go.
All right, here we go.
Big voice, big voice.
In sixth place at the moment, we have Going Live with 27 points. Closely followed with Vietnam Vets with 36 points. Then Hipster Indictment in fourth place with 37. Three. The Prof Squad in third place with 39 points. And in second with 41 points, Scooby Snacks, the Spanish Marina, the Fever of the Toto with 43 points.
Not done yet, though. Show us not over yet. Premature celebration. Right. Yeah, okay. Now, if Nathan Abbey is still around,
yes,
we'd like
sure.
you to come back
Abby
up
and
do a draw.
Have
you named Captain Abbey this year?
Very
good. Camp. The camp of us can wait. Now, it's time for, basically, all of you, I guess, have a raffle ticket. All of you are in with a chance. Those wonderful prizes donated by our celebrities is going to go to someone.
Yes.
We've got three levels of prize. We're going to draw number one first,
yes.
Then two and three.
And we've got so many other fantastic prizes as well. You would have read it out there.
We don't have time. There are two levels of prizes.
Yes. One and two.
That's how it works. We're going to
draw.
We don't have time for a third prize.
I know. First prize first, huh?
Yeah, first, that makes sense.
I'm going to hold this aloft. I'm going to
come
in between the two of you.
I think.
I'm not very tall, so there you go. Dig deep, do whatever you want to do.
Don't forget to take it back.
There we go.
It is a blue ticket. No! And the number is?
It doesn't have a mic quite right. We didn't bring it.
I'll say yell into my ear, but that's fine. It is B70.
Ticket,
and we'll come up later and
we will find you after the show.
Oh, because we all want to see that Trump pencil sharpener so bad.
So hang on to your ticket. We will hang on to this half and
yes,
and we will find you and you'll find us.
All right, Abby.
Okay, second prize. Here we go.
Up. And it is
another blue ticket.
And it is D for D. 83. D for December, 83. Where are you?
There we go,
sure.
Yes.
Waving your hands in the darkness is good, but yelling out also helps. We did that, guys. That's what we do. Thank you, Nate. Thank you, Andy. Well done, thank you to our raffle winners. Thank you all of you for buying a ticket as well, remembering that all proceeds going to Canteen. Thank you very much. You are amazing people.
And we just have to do a little blurb about Improv Australia classes.
Oh my gosh, would you like to do what you're seeing here?
Yes! Yeah.
All you have to do is achieve fame as a Matilda, go to the Olympics and the FIFA World Cup, and we will one day invite you to be on this stage.
Yeah.
Or
you can do some classes, look up Improv Australia on the net, online, go, wow, yeah, I want to do that. You do a series of weeks, meet like-minded people, start easy, get the basic skills, build, and yeah, maybe one day, like these guys here, huh?
It is great fun.
Have some fun,
use
your brain.
Improv Australia, check it out. Improv
Australia,
IA. Yep. On the Instagram.
That's it.
That's how I find them. They're right.
Beautiful. What? What is everyone looking at me? Okay. Oh, well, here we are. At the pointy end there.
Oh, I thought I felt something.
Yeah. I know. Shall we just slide on?
Let's just go straight.
Let's just go straight in. What are we hanging around for? Okay.
We're climbing over furniture now. It's that point in the day.
It's all
right.
What we call an all-in, man.
Going to call an all-in?
It's an all-in. That means everyone here, all-in, we're going to share the love. A little bit of communal, you know, whatever you want to call it. Communal improv.
Bring this baby home.
Bring this baby home, yeah.
Okay, so, what should we do?
What are you feeling?
A nice big epic scene?
Maybe they're looking for something.
Okay, like a quest.
A quest.
Right.
And they're looking for, I don't know, higher consciousness, higher ground, love, peace. I don't know what we're going to be looking for. Something really basic, like the Garfields. Yeah.
What do you think?
I think something simple.
Okay.
Yeah.
Car keys.
Oh, car keys. There you go.
Car keys is a winner. All right.
Car keys it is.
It's an epic quest for the car keys.
The car keys have gone missing.
With all teams.
Yes, they do.
Up on stage. Come on up. All our performers. Stretch the legs for now.
And this can be anything and everything. It can be musical. It can be Shakespeare. It can be who knows.
Yeah, what? Every
you know, elements of
element
everything.
Element of every game you've seen so far, with every performer on stage.
It's just all in.
Where the hell this one could go?
All in, all happening. We're going to get out of your way.
All
this
right.
Is big, baby.
I feel. Why is everyone looking at me? All right.
Are you starting, Rove? Of course you are.
All right.
Here we go. In 5, 4, 3, 2.
That first bit didn't count. Kids! All 8 of my kids! Mary Jr., Claire, Lynette! Look, I don't have time for
all of you.
I will, but honey!
Hi! And
Moise
in the car.
Oh, no! Okay, yours is in the
car.
It's
very hot.
Is any of you seen
it? I told you not to leave Mum in the car when it was hot.
I'm missing one of my kids. He dribbles a lot, but I need you to somehow work out a way to get into this car.
Okay.
Well, I go hunting for the key.
Probably better hurry.
I'm going to
hurry,
man.
Meanwhile, at a Turkish belly dancing lesson.
So never dance like this. This is not when to dance for belly. Ahmed here knows how to dance belly dance. Sure, Ahmed.
Thank you.
Batu, the lair of the pelican.
We've seen some amazing highlights, but there's only one that we deem to be the moment of the match. And when we have voted for this, we will then get the participants in that scene to get back up and recreate it in slow motion.
Right, so let's throw to our head charge, Lynn Pierce, for the moment of the match.
We did. Rival of the Teletubbies.
Teams were split by 2 points tonight.
Ooh.
It was very, very close. Second team was 41 points. Our first team was on 43 points. And our winners of the night are... We've got a Matilda!
There we go. We've rewritten history. Yeah, fine. That's all the applause we needed. That's fine. That's all we needed.